Yeah, you're welcome to my channel. Yeah, we want to continue the second part of the auxiliary projection of the block that we started in the first video. Now we have been able to draw the plan and elevation of the block, and we have been able to label the front elevation. Now we also need to label the plan so that we don't need to do it twice. Now that means we have to look at it from the top. Now, looking downward. So at this corner, we have A at the top and G at the bottom. That is this corner, we have A and G. Then this corner, we have only F. Here we have F. At this corner, which is here, we have E at the top. And going down, we have P. Remember, E going down and K going backward will meet at P. So we have E and P at that corner. We have E and P at that corner. Now, at this corner, we have D at the top and O at the bottom. We have D and O. Then this corner, we have C, only C. So we have C here. Then this other corner, we have B at the top and under, coming down, and N going backward, they meet at Q. So we have Q at the bottom. So we have B and Q. We have B here and Q. So moving to the front now. At this point, we have J at the top and H at the bottom. J, H. Then here we have K. K. Then at this corner, viewing it from the top, so we have only L. This is L, and finally here, viewing from the top, we have N and M. We have M and N. M and N. So that is the labeling of the two, like of the plan and elevation. So now we are left to we now connect and draw the auxiliary plan of the object. Now we are working on the elevation. We take our dimension from the plan, so meaning we have to transfer this value to this side. You rotate it, all the value on this side, just rotate them like this and place them here. So if you rotate, that means this one that is the G and H that is there will now be at the top. Our bottom will start from here. So at this bottom, along this line, we have, let us, okay, let me do it. Let's erase this. Let's put our Y one here. So extend the line out along this base, which is here now. We have J, we have H, K, we have L, we have M and N. Now remember, we are rotating like this. So the total length, we need to measure the total length, which is 76. After scaling it, it will give us 38. To give us 38, 10, 20, 30, 38 is here. So you transfer this this line to that point. You remember, we are rotating like this. So this portion will now be at the top. This one will be at the bottom. By the time we rotate it like this. So we now measure this small distance there, which is 6 here. Here is 6. So you also transfer that one. Make sure it is parallel. So along this line now, which is this point now, we have F, E, P, E, P, D, O, C. Then here we have A, G, B, Q. Now So the next thing is to begin our projection. So let us now begin to link along this line. Let us connect A to B. A to B. Where is A here? This is A coming here. A is coming out from this line. It's coming along here. Where is A along here? This is A. So A is around this point. That's where we have our A. Again, we are tracing A. A is coming here, coming to this place, meeting A, because this is where we have A. And we want to connect A to B, so let us trace B, because A is connected to B here. Let us trace B too. This is B. Where is B here? B is also along this line. It is meeting B here. Now, B is connected to C. Let us connect B to C. Where is B to C? This is B along this line and connected to C. You can see this is C. So it is connected here and they are connected to a straight line. You can link them like that. Now, similarly, A is connected to F here. You can see A and F are on this point. We have located A. So F is also on that line. Where is F? F is here. So A and F are here. So they are connected like this. Yeah, good. Now, F is connected to J. We have located F. Let us locate J. This is our F. Where is J? J is coming from this point. From this point. Where is J? J is along this line. So J is here. And F is connected to J. So you connect F. Yeah, F to J, yes. Connect F to J like that. Now, similarly, E is connected to, let's do it this way first. J is connected to K. Let us look for K. You have seen J. This is our J. And where is K? K is coming from here, along this line. And K is also along this line. So K is here. So they are connected like this. Now, K is connected to E. You connect K to E. This is our K. Where is E? E is coming here. E is along this line. And E is here. So this is our E. And they are connected together. You connect them like that. Now, we are done with that. Let's move to this side. Now, we have done B to C. This is B to C. Now, C is connected to M. So let us locate M. M, this is M. We trace it down. M is here. So M is here. You can see. This is M. It's here. And it's connected to this one. It is connected to C. So you connect it like that. Now, also, C is connected to D. Where is D? D is coming like this. This is D. Look at it. D is coming connected to D here. And D, that is, D is connected to C, and C is here. C is here. So you connect C to D like this. Now, then D is connected to L. Where is L? L is here, along this line. Where is L here? L is up here. So it is here. Look at it, going back to L. So you connect this together. Now, also we have L connected to M. Remember, this is L. And this is M. Look at it, M. So they are connected together. You connect them. If you look at it critically again, you see that K is also connected to L. Where is K? K. K is here. This is K. Look at it, K. K. is connected to L, and this is L. Look at it, L. So that means over here, this one too, they are connected. So you can just draw the straight line to the end like that. So that is that. Now we have M. M is connected to N. Have we done that? M to N, where is M? This is M connected to N. Okay, we have connected that. Now here, this vertical line, A is connected to G. Where is our A? Our A is here. Our A is here along this line, but A is up here. So this is our A, is connected to G. And where is G? G is coming. G is coming like this. You can see this is A and this is G. Look at it, G, G. So G is here. So that means this one, they are connected with straight line like this. Similarly, H is connected to N. Where is H? This is H. H is also along this line. And where is H? And H is here. So our H is somewhere here. And H is connected to N. Where is N? N is here. This is N. N is somewhere here. So they are connected. So that means the straight line will extend to the end. To the end, like that. Now, let us look at our D now. This line, we have not done this line. This, this, and this. So let us look at D connected to O. Where is D? This is our D. D is here. And D is connected to O. Where is O? O is here. This one. It's connected to O here. You see? This is O. And this is D. Look at it. It's tracing backward. It is D. So they are connected like this. This is connected to O like this. Now, similarly, D is connected to O and O is connected to L. Let us look for L. L is along this line. L is here. So L is here. Let us look at it again. Yeah, L is here and it's connected to O. Remember, our O is here. Look at it, O. O, so O is here. That means this line is connected to this line. So you connect this one with thick line because this what is visible, you can see it, this thick line. Now we have connected O to L, and O is also connected to this P. Where is P? P is here. P is coming like this. P is along this line. So P is here. Our P is here. This is our P. And P is connected to O. Where is O? Look at O. This is O. Again, look at O is coming like this. And it's O here. So that means this line is connected to this line. So, but this time around, by the time you draw it up to this point, you stop. From here to here, you cannot see it. It is hidden line. It is hidden line here because this face, the whole of this face, is covering it. Similarly, this is our P. Yes, P. It's also connected to, what is it connected? P at this point is also connected to E. If you know, that is going upward. P is connected to E. This is our P. And where is our E? Our E. This is, if this is P, where is E? E is here. Oh, we have done that. I've done that. Now P is connected to, P is connected, also connected to K. You can see P is coming, when K move backward, it will meet P. So P is connected to K. Where is K? K is along this line. Let us trace K here. This K is coming here. So K is here. K is here. Look at it. K. K is connected to P. is connected to P, and this is our P. So meaning you have another line here. Again, this one too will be hidden line. It will be hidden line because the whole of this face is covering this portion, and the whole of this place is covering the other one. Now, what do we have here? We have B here. B is connected to A. Have you done that? Here we have connected B to A. Aha, this is our A. A coming here. A is here. So B is connected to A, like this. So this one, the whole of this bottom will be thick line. This is B and this is A. Look at A. You can see A coming like this and going that way. And B coming like this and going this way. So that's how they are connected. Similarly, what do we have here? We have G here. G is connected to H and A. G is connected to H, is connected to A, and it's connected to Q. And see, this at the back is connected to Q. When B goes down and Q goes this way, they will meet at Q. So that means G is connected to Q. Now we have said this is G is connected to Q. Where is Q? Q is here. Oh, we have connected that one. There's a connection between H. This is H. And what do we have here? We have G here. Is G connected? Yeah, G is connected to H. You can see G is connected to H. This is our H here. Look at it. H is connected to G. You can see this is G here. So we have a straight line here, like this. So that is is it? I think there's still a joint here. What do we have here? We have M here. M is connected to N. We have done that. M to N like this. M is also connected to L. M connected to L. M connected to L here this way. M and N. Where is N? N is here, connected to this. So they're still supposed to. What do we have here? This is what we have here. I think. So we have our N here. Look at it. N going backward, it will be connected to Q. Remember, Q is when B comes down to Q, N also goes to Q. So N connected to Q. Let us connect that. Where is our N? This is our N here, somewhere here. Here. Now see, this is N connected to Q. Where is Q? Q is on the same spot and Q is here. So it is here like this. So this portion, and it will be hidden line because it is at the back. So that will be the solution to the auxiliary plan. So do endeavor to like the video, share it, and subscribe to the channel if you have really enjoyed this video. Thank you very much. We will continue the auxiliary elevation in the next video.